Here you have to put it in theory also. Okay. See here, this is the arrangement for the this experiment. Here in this one, here you have to use the one capacitor, one resistors, and four keys. That is K1, K2, K3, and K4. And you have to use the one MOS key. That is tapping key K. And also you have to use the ballistic calorimeters for the showing of the deflection. And you have to use the battery. Okay. See here. During the SWAT experiment, somewhere is leakage. Okay, that doing for that leakage, you have to find out the how much of high resistance you have to calculate it here. Okay, see here during the leakage of an axle, during this leakage, you can see here the capacitor is goes on decreasing. At that time, there is no potential difference. If there is no potential difference, then automatically EMF is not produced. Okay. Therefore, E equal to 0. Starting E equal to 0. That is, during the discharge action of the capacitor, E equal to 0. And you have to know the EMF equation. E equal to IR plus Q by C. Okay. If E equal to 0, therefore, IR plus Q by C equal to 0. All that is equation number 1. And you have to know the by the definition of the current. That is, I equal to dQ by dt. Put that I value in equation number 1. We have to get R into, that is dQ by dt plus Q by C, which is equal to 0. Take Q by C, RHS side. We have to get R into dQ by dt is equal to minus Q by C. Therefore, take this or rearrange the terms. That is dQ by dt equal to minus dt divided by RC. Okay. Now, integrate both sides to this equation. That is integration of dQ by Q is equal to integration of minus dt divided by RC. Okay, integration of this term, you have to know that is ln Q to the base, which is equal to, here take the constant term outside, that is minus and 1 by RC constant, you have to take that. Remaining term, integration of dt, integration of dt is t, that is therefore, which is equal to minus t divided by RC plus integration constant K. So that is equation number 2. See here, if initially there is no, if you are not starting this experiment, that time t equal to 0, time is 0. If time is 0, means there is no flow of charges. At that time, Q equal to Q naught. Here, Q naught is the initial charge. Okay. Therefore, above equation becomes, equation 2 becomes, means here t becomes 0, this term 0, and Q is Q naught. Therefore, K equal to log Q naught to the base K. Okay, put this K value again in equation number 2. Log Q, which is equal to minus T by RC plus, here put the K value, that is log Q naught. Well, that is equation number 3. Therefore, take this term, this side. Okay, that is log Q naught minus log Q, which is equal to T divided by RC. Again, here you use the log property, that is log U minus log V, which is equal to log U by E. Here, therefore, log Q naught by Q is equal to minus T by RC. Okay, see here this equation. For this one, log, here base is E. If you have to get base is E, if you have to get the base 10, means you have to multiply by 2.303. Already you have to know this one. Therefore, 2.303 log Q naught by Q to the base 10, which is equal to minus 3 divided by RC. All that is equation number 4. Therefore, rearrange this one, that is R equal to T divided by 2.303 into C into log Q naught by Q. Okay. Next, we know that the capacitance definition, that is C equal to Q by P. Okay. Initially, the value of capacitance, that is Q is also 0, there is no potential. Therefore, C equal to Q by V and C equal to Q naught by P. You have to take. Therefore, comparing this equation, we have to write Q by P is equal to Q naught by P naught. Okay. Q by P is equal to Q naught by V naught. Or see here, these are proportional to each other. Therefore, Q by Q naught, Q naught by Q equal to P naught by P. Okay, put this Q naught by Q value in this equation. Means we have to get R equal to T divided by 2.303 into C into log Q naught by Q, means Q naught by Q means, that is V naught by P. Okay. See here. Next, see this diagram. Suppose initially the key K1 and K4 are pressed. If you have to press that one,
then capacitor gets charged, press and again release that one. Okay, at that time you have to tap this mouse key, that is K. If you have to tap that mouse key or mouse key, then automatically the ballistic galvanometer which is connected to this one, the ballistic galvanometer shows the deflection. Why it can show the deflection? Because if you have to on this both the keys K1 and K4 and this MOS key, at that time the capacitor gets charged. If capacitor gets charged means the charges are flowing. If the charges are flowing, then automatically there is potential difference is produced. Okay, therefore the automatically the ballistic element shows the deflection. Okay. See here, first for this one, first deflection is you have to take as theta naught, and for that potential difference is V naught. Okay, both are directly proportional to each other. Okay. Similarly, you can do this procedure continuously. That is, you have to get P1 is directly proportional to theta 1 and V2 is directly proportional to theta 2 and so on. Okay. Because therefore, comparing these equations, we have to write V naught by U1 is equal to theta naught by theta 1. Put this V0 by V1 value in this situation. You have to get, that is R equal to T divided by 2.303 into C into log V0 by V means here theta naught by theta 1. That is log theta naught by theta 1 to the base 10. That is called equation number 3. Okay, see here, the value of theta 1 here, it is varies or changes by changing the value of T. Okay. Okay, now we have to plot the graph, that is using these two terms, that is log theta naught by theta 1 to the base 10 and T. If you have to plot the graph for log theta naught by theta 1 versus T, you have to get the graph like this, means you have to get the straight line here. Okay, if you have to get the straight line, you have to point out the, that is slope. Okay, that slope is given by here. Okay, see here, slope of that graph is definitely log theta naught by theta 1 divided by T. Okay, put this value, that is slope in equation number 3. We have to get R equal to CR 1 divided by 2.303 into T into slope. Because you have to write slope, because log theta naught by theta 1 divided by T means that is slope. Therefore, R equal to 1 divided by 2.303 into C into slope.